I'm sitting in front of a craft beer couple at the Twins game, and they keep going, "That's not beer," to the poor vendor selling Bud Light. Imagine being so uninteresting that you think this counts as a personality. Oh my God, I can only imagine. "Oh, that's not beer. This is real beer. You haven't even tried real beer until you try this." "Okay, bro, I don't care. You're not better than me because you like a different kind of beer. You're so special because you've discovered something new." Oh my God, I'm so excited for this video, guys. You have no idea. These sorts of people are so funny. Guys, welcome back. Hope you're having a great day so far. Thank you so much for tuning back in. Today, we're checking out a brand new subreddit, r/gatekeeping. A few of you wonderful people at home recommended this subreddit to me, so thank you so much. I had no idea it even existed until you guys recommended it to me, so thank you. Even looking over it to get this video ready, I think it's one of my favorite subreddits so far. It's so damn funny. Okay, guys, today's a really good day. Hope you're doing well. Thank you so much for being here, and thank you for all your support. You're all incredible. Let's not waste any more time. Let's jump in, do some gatekeeping. Gray sweatpants are for dudes with ding dong. Not dudes with pee-pees. Yeah, but if I say leggings are for witches with ass, not ones with long backs, I'm the bad guy. Yeah, 100%. And it's probably just meant to be a joke. I feel like it's become a joke now. Like, oh, if he wears gray sweatpants, that means you can, you know, you can see, you can see his, and like, you know, you can't really ever take anything seriously on Twitter. So I'm sure she's not being serious, but it's still hilarious. People really be grown and still using umbrellas. What, are you supposed to become waterproof after you turn 18 or something? Oh my God. You are literally an immature child if you use an umbrella. God, no one after the age of 18 should ever use an umbrella. You just stand out in the rain and get wet like an adult. I am better than you because I don't use an umbrella. A lot of these gatekeeping things are just really, really dumb. These people take pride in the dumbest things in the world, like not using an umbrella. Or like a really common one is driving a manual instead of driving an automatic. And being like, if you drive an automatic, you're an absolute beta male. Just really shallow stuff that doesn't matter, basically. But yeah, now that I'm 21 years old, I am never gonna use an umbrella ever again, okay? Sorry for that. This one from the Choosing Beggars. $2 is not a tip. $5 is not a tip. Anything I give you outside this bill is the tip. Yeah, 100%. I read this exact post in a Choosing Beggars video, like early on this channel. Well, not early. It was only a couple of months ago. But yeah, absolutely. Anything you get on top of what it's paid, that's a tip. Doesn't matter how much it is, you might want a bigger tip, but it still doesn't mean that $2 isn't a tip or $5 isn't a tip. Maybe that's all they have, okay? What's the one thing that no writer should ever do? No writer should ever write an experience story that isn't theirs to write. If you're a straight white dude, you don't write about the experience of coming out as a trans black girl. Write diverse casts, but don't write the experience of something that needs to come from another. JK Rowling wrote about a schoolboy's experience and she did pretty well. Yeah, oh my God, you're taking the fun out of something like writing. A creative outlet, somewhere where people can just do whatever they want. You know, they can write these fantasies, they can write these crazy things that never happened. Do you really think Stephen King was a murderer? God damn, that's so frustrating. I can't stand it when people are like that. This is a creative outlet where people can literally do whatever they want. That's the point of fictional writing. You get to write something and create a world that is so much more vivid and so much more exciting than your own world. Like, don't take that away from people, dude. 1 month cigarette free, hell yeah. 9 years, mother fricker. Congratulate yourself after 2 years minimum, or be prepared to start the loop again. Dude, okay, bro. Just because that's your experience doesn't mean it's everybody else's experience. I've never smoked cigarettes before. I'm sure it is very, very hard to quit smoking. And this guy obviously knows that because he's talking about how he hasn't smoked in 9 years. So shouldn't you really be encouraging this person to keep not smoking instead of making them feel bad? You know, maybe it'll be too tough to get through the first 2 years of not smoking. You need to congratulate yourself on your little wins. They keep you motivated and they keep you focused. And this is really important, dude. It's like losing weight. I'm trying to lose weight right now. I am losing weight right now. I'm working out every day and I'm eating really, really well. But when I go and have a shower and I look in the mirror and I'm not the way I want to look, do I expect myself to look the way I want to look tomorrow? No. You're just trying to be better than you were yesterday. And 1 month cigarette free is pretty awesome. I don't know if that made any sense, but I think you guys know what I mean. People born in 1999, people born from 2000 to 2003 that grew up with the exact same things. 100%. I was born in 1999. And trust me, is really hard to fight the temptation to talk like that. I've known so many people like that. You don't understand this. You weren't even born, bro. Only 90s kids will understand that. I've never said that because I wasn't even really born in the 90s. It's not like when I was 1 year old in the 90s that I could remember it. You see this sort of stuff with trends all the time. Or if somebody that's like 15 years old now starts to like Nirvana or something, everyone's like, you don't even know who that is. I was still alive when Kurt Cobain was alive. And like, dude, you would never really truly appreciate the music like I did. Dude, no. Okay? And like fashion trends and stuff like that. Everybody wants to dress like super 90s style. And there's nothing wrong with that. It looks good. I think everyone just needs to be more open to everything, you know? It's okay. And you're not better than somebody else just because you're a little bit older. My parents couldn't afford to buy me a fancy cake this year. So after a long day of work, my dad came home and made me one. That's so damn beautiful. The fact that at age 20, you're still having your parents buy you a birthday cake. The fact that however old you are and you're still commenting that sort of crap. Get out of here, dude. You are not taking that away from this person and you're not taking that away from me either. That's such a beautiful, wholesome, happy, positive thing. And you just have to make it bad. Don't spread your negativity onto other people, bro. Keep it to yourself. Let's confuse the 2000s kids. Literally not one 2000s kid is confused. Yeah, who would be confused? I had PE as well. The bottom right, those little scooter things, I was always way too fat for them. Like, I used to sit on them and the wheels just didn't work. That's so funny and I totally forgot they existed. I've never done that bottom left one though. I love how you just forget about something forever and then you see a picture and it just reminds you immediately. Like, I guess I was just so upset that I could never actually use those scooter things that I pushed it out of my mind. When you get in your friend's new sports car and see that it's an automatic. Dude, if you don't drive a manual, you're an absolute loser. It's definitely a personal preference thing. It's totally fine to just want to drive a manual until you start making memes like this and until you start making other people feel bad because they don't do what you do. Not everyone's the same. Not everyone values the same things that you do. And you need to understand that. I drive a manual car and I can't wait to get an automatic. I am so sick of changing gears. It doesn't make you more like, what, manly because you have an automatic? Okay. For me, anyway, I live in a rural place, so it is sort of important that I know how to drive a manual. Before I did YouTube, I did some work at some mine sites and stuff, and it is important that you know how to drive a manual for like things like that because you'll be jumping into other people's cars and like work cars and stuff, and they might be manual, and it's just a pain if you don't know how to drive it. But if I was getting my license right now, I probably wouldn't get a manual. For a lot of people, it's just more hassle than it's worth. Kids nowadays don't know nothing about these. Yeah, because that's how time works. Exactly right. Okay, I'm sorry I don't still have a DS or a PSP. That brings back a lot of sad memories about the DS. I used to have a bunk bed when I was little, and I dropped my DS off the top of it, and it broke on the carpet, and I got so damn upset. And that was the end of it for me. No more DS. You can still get these things now. You can still enjoy them now. It's just nostalgic now. It's just sort of weird to be like, oh, in my day, we had worse technology than we do now. Okay, everyone else knows that as well. The exact same thing is going to happen when kids nowadays get old. They're going to be like, oh my God, I remember when the PlayStation 4 came out. We thought it was the coolest thing in the world. And like, their kids are playing on like a PlayStation 35. You know what I mean? It's never going to change and it doesn't make you different. Only art students or art enthusiasts will get how cool this watch is. Literally everyone knows who Salvador Dali is. Dude, you have to be different and you have to be quirky to understand this. That's a really cool watch and I think everyone should be able to enjoy it. I don't know if it's just people that are trying to be different from other people. Like what they're doing here with the art students or art enthusiasts. They're saying that like, oh, if you're not one of us, you can't enjoy this watch. Don't be like that. I'm sorry, I'm not that good at painting. What do you want me to say? Well done. My kids are in charge of the thermostat. I have a favorite Taylor Swift song. I pay a landscaping company to cut my grass. My wife and I have sex on weekdays sometimes. Hardware store employees ask me for help. If you don't get your steak absolutely blue and just bleeding, you are not a man. This masculinity stuff is just sad, dude. Are you really that boring, dude? To the point where you have to brag about how you like your food cooked. It's just embarrassing, really. Me, I just saw a great movie. Someone who read the book, no. Yeah, that's so damn true. Oh my God, no, you don't even understand how good it is. Pet Sematary is one of my favorite old Stephen King movies. And like, I was talking about that to some friends and they were even the same. Like, oh dude, it's nothing compared to the book. The movie was pretty good. Can I just enjoy that, please? But I actually did get the book and I'm probably going to read that because Stephen King's books aren't awesome. But yeah, that sort of stuff can get really frustrating. It's like, dude, I just like the movie. Can I just enjoy it, please? It's gay as hell for a man to take a nap. Oh my my God, that's so funny. You know, obviously just an absolute load of crap, and don't take that seriously whatsoever, please. But I feel like this sort of stuff is why a lot of people like Twitter, just because you don't know what to expect and you're just gonna get nonsense after nonsense. Like, that just makes absolutely no sense, but it's sort of shocking. Like, I can't believe that somebody said that. It's gay for a man to take a nap. You know, as a person, I am pretty secure in my beliefs, but I guess I better not have any more naps. Water drinkers, cold or room temperature? No one who actually drinks water prefers cold. Okay, as much as I agree with you, you can't gatekeep water. We literally need it to live. I don't know if it's just because I have really sensitive teeth, but I can't drink water that's really cold. This top comment, I like my water deep fried with seasoning. Oh my God, dude, I love people on Reddit so much. Guys who drive an automatic, my car is automatic. Guys who drive a manual, I will never drive an automatic because I'm a real driver and I am one with my machine. After I drive, I put the shifter in my because me and my machine are one. Yeah, a little bit of an exaggeration, but that's about right, dude. I've been learning a lot about indifference lately and how important it is to just not have opinions sometimes. Not that it exactly relates to this, but a lot of people nowadays just feel like they need to have a strong opinion on everything, and I really don't. I'm absolutely happy being the sort of person who just doesn't really care. Depends what it is, obviously, and the stuff I'm passionate about I have opinions on. But like, dude, I couldn't care less if you drive a manual or an automatic or you take naps. And I think that's very important. Basically, just not caring about stuff that really doesn't matter. Hey guy with a hydration pack, two hiking sticks and a North Face vest. My 5-year-old walked the same trail in Crocs carrying a naked Barbie. Relax. Oh, okay. Sorry that your 5-year-old is a super athlete. Taking something as natural and fun and awesome and beautiful as like going for a hike, you know, on a beautiful sunny day, you can hear the birds chirping. You can feel the sun on the back of your neck. It's like a beautiful day. There's no wind whatsoever. And you just have to suck the fun out of it, don't you? There's always going to be people that are just annoying, and you'll find them on this subreddit. I can't help but roll my eyes at those who miss their fiancés or husbands after them only being gone for a few weeks. Oh, I'm sorry, I love my partner. I miss Jess after like 3 days of not being with her. And you're not changing my opinion on that, okay? Just because your partner might be away for longer doesn't mean you're better than everyone else. Like, they just want to be different. And you get this with everything. People just want to rub it in that they're different than you, even though they're not. And yeah, I'm just not going to listen to somebody that's telling me that I shouldn't miss my partner. Okay. Don't invite me on a vacation if you stay in hotels like this. Okay, you're not coming. End of story. If you feel like you're entitled enough to just be invited on vacation with someone and have them cover all the costs, such a choosing beggar. How annoying. Have fun staying at home then. If your boyfriend reads books, that's a girlfriend. Oh my God, how can someone be that nuts? What if it's a book on carpentry or like coal mining? A real man would learn hands-on, risking his fingers on an electric saw. Oh, that's got to be a joke. It has to be. I'm really finding it hard to believe that somebody is that crazy. But like, dude, I say that pretty much every video, and every time I'm surprised. Apparently, it's just not masculine enough to read a book. A person should never have to feel bad for doing something fun. Whether you're reading like an awesome fantasy story, or you're reading like Tony Robbins' book and you're trying to improve yourself, you shouldn't have to feel bad about those things. Stop taking the good things in life away from us, please. I'm not customizing my home screen. I'm 24 years old. Yeah, you don't sound like much fun either, Megan. Oh, nah, when you grow up, you just have to be boring and have no fun. Dude, I'm gonna have cakes when I'm 40, 50, 60. I'm gonna be customizing my home screen. I'm gonna be watching Simpsons when I'm old, dude. Because life really is about the little things. Little things throughout the day that make you happy. And you know what? You should never have to feel bad for having fun doing something that doesn't hurt anybody else. This is probably just meant to be a joke, but I feel like a lot of these people are just trying to fit in. And they're like, oh, this is what we're meant to do when we hit this age, right? It's like, no, dude, just do what you want. Have fun. You're gonna die one day. This isn't coffee. This is coffee. Oh my God, don't get me started on the coffee snobs. Oh my God, you put sweetener or sugar in your coffee and you put milk in it. Oh my God, you're ruining it. As they sip on a boring coffee that tastes like garbage water. Like, I'm sorry, I want to make it taste better. I guess I'm not a connoisseur like you. Dude, you're high if you think these potato cubes are considered hash browns. Ketchup is unacceptable if you are over the age of 12, and always unacceptable with breakfast. Disgusting, sickly, sweet bastardization of the glorious tomato. Hey, bro, are you done talking? Because nobody's listening to you. If I want to eat tomato sauce at 21 years old, then I'm allowed to, okay, bro? Pretty much nothing to do with food is unacceptable. A few things are, but eating tomato sauce over a certain age definitely isn't. How ridiculous. Guys, I think that's a wonderful time to end this video here. I really hope you enjoyed it. That went fast. I had so much fun today. And I guess time flies when you're having fun. If you guys enjoyed this video and you want to see a part 2, let me know down in the comment section below. below. I really like this subreddit. Thank you guys so much for suggesting it to me. You've opened my eyes to a whole world of crazy people. Today's comment of the day goes to Marshall. Today is my 19th birthday and 5th anniversary of when I got my cat. We're chilling, binging your videos, and the day couldn't get better. That's so damn awesome, and happy birthday. And give your cat a big hug for me, dude. I'm gonna go hug Chico right now. Dude, if you hug a cat over the age of 12, you're not a man. Today was so much fun. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you smash like, make sure you subscribe. And yeah, guys, thanks for being the best. You're all amazing. Have a lovely day, have a lovely night, and I'll see you tomorrow at the exact same time with 2 brand new videos. I'll see you guys then.